So I've used VPNs for ages, but even after years, there's just nothing more infuriating than VPN blocks. This, you piece, look, I paid for my VPN, okay? And I'm not gonna have some cheeky website preventing me from using it. So, here in this video, I'm gonna show you 5 effective bypass VPN block methods. Now, you gotta know that most of the time you're gonna find site blocked because of VPN because of these 3 reasons: geographical restrictions, government censorship, and institutional policies. Now, how exactly do they manage it? Well, they either use IP address blocking or deep packet inspection. The former relies on straight up banning all IP addresses affiliated with VPN services. The latter checks all the traffic passing through in search of specific patterns associated with VPN traffic. Both of those methods are pretty effective, but not infallible. As I've mentioned, there are 5 ways of how to make your VPN undetectable. The first is pretty simple. You can try changing VPN servers or the VPN protocol in use. Changing the server is also changing the IP address you're using. And since IP blocking can't possibly account for all the servers and the IPs, changing the server can bypass that particular blocking method. Since I typically use VPNs with thousands of servers and even more IP addresses, this kind of method is more reliable than it may seem, especially in the case of Surfshark VPN. Its Nexus technology is created for IP rotating, so it's easier to make VPN undetectable. Alternatively, you can try using a different VPN protocol. The classic option in most scenarios is the OpenVPN protocol, which most providers use by default, but being classic makes it more predictable. These days, WireGuard and its variations such as NordVPN's NordLinks are a better option to use against VPN blocking, as they are even harder to detect. Talking about detection, some providers even create special measures or VPN protocols to conceal VPN traffic, like NordWhisper protocol or Surfshark's stealth mode feature. So if you want to start bypassing VPN blocks right now, look no further than these QR codes or the link in the description. That's where you can find an exclusive deal for the best VPNs. Now, since I've mentioned features, here's the second way to bypass VPN blocks. Use them. Now, the VPN providers came up with many features against IP address blocking and deep packet inspection. Obfuscated servers are a very widespread one. They hide VPN traffic, making it appear as regular online activity. NordVPN, ProtonVPN, and Surfshark all have this feature, though it's called No Borders in Surfshark's case. The Tor over VPN feature is also effective at concealing VPN traffic. Tor stands for the Onion Router, and it's an extremely secure peer-to-peer network. NordVPN and ProtonVPN can use this network as an addition to the usual VPN connection. It's borderline impossible for ISPs and even governments to deal with Tor's anonymity measures. However, the resulting connection is really slow as a downside. Alternatively, you can get a dedicated IP address, which will be unique to your connection, so IP address blocking measures become completely useless. My only issue with dedicated IP is that it's usually an extra purchase on top of VPNs, and this is true for NordVPN, Surfshark, and ProtonVPN. So if you want to get a dedicated IP, consider grabbing a VPN discount to save money. You can find one through the links in the description, just letting you know. Now, as for the third method, this one is focused mostly on how to use VPN to bypass deep packet inspection. Proxy tunnels work quite well against it, and VPNs actually often offer free proxy services like the SOX 5 proxy. That said, out of my top 3 providers, only NordVPN has SOX 5 proxy among its features, and even then, you need to keep in mind that the proxies don't encrypt your traffic, so even when you bypass DPI, you will still be more exposed to online dangers than when using VPN normally. Because of that, some providers like ProtonVPN have straight up released manifestos against SOX 5 usage. Now, so far I've discussed methods with an expectation that your VPN is working properly. That said, if you're not using a top VPN, chances are simple DNS leaks are the cause of VPN blocks. So let's fix those. First of all, consider checking your connection with this DNS leak test. It's easy to use, but just in case, keep your eyes on the screen. I've been showing you the steps to take for the last 5 seconds or so. If the test comes positive, this means you have a DNS leak. Usually, if you have a good VPN, enabling DNS leak protection should get rid of the issue. Alternatively, you can use private DNS. Just keep in mind that not every VPN provider offers this feature. Not to say that you can't use public DNS, but I wouldn't recommend that, as this is a very direct privacy issue. In rare cases, the split tunneling feature in your VPN can also cause DNS leaks. This has happened to me before, so the easiest fix is to disable the feature. Not permanently, but usually a patch or 2 fixes this issue, so keep these things in mind. So far, I've provided advice that could help you if you're using a majority of VPN providers. But can you get VPN undetectable if your VPN simply sucks? Sadly, I don't think so. Now, in this case, changing to a more private VPN with features against VPN blocks has got to be your only solution. Some VPNs are just more effective at dealing with IP address blocking or deep packet inspection. As I've mentioned earlier, you want a VPN with a lot of servers and special features that can negate DPI. Now, I've listed a few options during this video, so if you want to give them a try, remember, I do have discount links for those in the description below. I also keep full feature reviews of VPNs on my channel, so leave a like, subscribe, get notified about new VPN and cybersecurity content. Now, I'm curious, if you manage to bypass VPN block with those methods, let me know in the comments which one helped you in your case. And if you have any questions left, don't hesitate to ask. And if you watched this far, I hope to see you in this exact same spot next time. Thanks for watching. See you soon. Bye.